click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, I welcome you all to this video. We are with the 13th chapter of microwave engineering, where the various performance parameters associated with the microwave signal are to be measured. The measurement techniques we have been addressing so far as like the VSWR measurement, the power measurement, frequency measurement, attenuation measurement, phase shift measurement, impedance measurement we have covered. Also in the previous lecture we have reported how the insertion loss can be measured by using the attenuation measurement as well as the impedance measurement techniques, correspondingly by the RF substitution and that of the reflectometer techniques here. Now I hope we are very well familiar to the devices as like the slotted line, the tunable detector, the various meters to measure the power, frequency, the network analyzer, the spectrum analyzer and so on. So now let us have the dielectric constant, which is a very very important parameter to categorize a particular material to be of the conductive or non-conductive type. So let us have the measurement of dielectric constant. So here we start with our topic, the dielectric constant measurement. The dielectric constant we refer to as is also denoted by the symbol epsilon suffix r here. So this suffix r is basically the relative dielectric constant. This dielectric constant is also referred to by the name permittivity. So the total permittivity or the total dielectric constant is equal to epsilon, which is the multiplication of epsilon 0 by epsilon r here. So epsilon 0 is permittivity of the free space or the air medium. So this is equal to 8.854 into 10 raised to power minus 12 farads per meter, or it is also given in terms of 1 upon 36 pi into 10 raised to the power 9 minus farads per meter here. So epsilon r is a constant value. So when it is multiplied to it, the relative value we have. So therefore, the complete permittivity for the given material medium we are able to determine here. So basically, for any material to know its particular type, we have the characteristic with respect to the sigma, the conductivity, the permeability denoted by mu, and this dielectric constant called as permittivity of the medium. So basically, conductivity is giving us the information how permissible the given medium is there to the flow of, to the passage of electric charge through it. Whereas mu gives us the information how the given material or the medium is permissible to the passage or the flow of magnetic force vector through it. Whereas epsilon gives us the information how the given material medium is permissible to the flow of electric vector through it. So we have to concentrate on this epsilon here. Now, if we take for example, the example of the polythene here. So for the polythene material, we have the conductivity value to be equal to 0. Whereas as it is of non-magnetic type, the mu value can be equal to 1 here. So it can be multiplied to that of mu 0 here, the constant value 4 pi into 10 raised to the power minus 7 Henry per meter for air or free space. So it will be the complete permeability of the polythene medium. And epsilon is a finite value. Now the epsilon value in general can be represented as epsilon, as before I have represented epsilon 0, and epsilon r can be splitted as epsilon dash minus epsilon double dash here. So in this representation, what we have, epsilon 0, this corresponds to the permittivity for free space. And inside the bracket, what we have represented, epsilon dash, this corresponds to the ability of the dielectric material medium to have storage of the energy. of course, the electric energy into it. Whereas epsilon double dash that we have represented is the measure of dissipation of the energy into that medium here. So I mentioned here energy through the medium. So this is the epsilon is equal to epsilon zero in bracket. We represent that difference of the two by epsilon r, the relative value here. So if you want to have epsilon r alone, you can take the ratio of generalized epsilon divided by epsilon zero, or you can take simply the difference epsilon dash minus j times epsilon double dash here. In the previous equation also, we require epsilon is equal to epsilon zero in multiplication to the bracket that has epsilon dash minus j times epsilon double dash. Then these are the meanings for the storage of the energy and dissipation of the energies here. Now next to this representation, the RHS for the relative dielectric constant epsilon r can be represented in terms of epsilon dash in the bracket 1 minus j times tan del here, where tan del is called as the loss tangent and it is the ratio of epsilon double dash divided by epsilon dash. So it is the ratio of the energy dissipated from the material medium to that of the energy stored in that particular material medium here. Now the ratio of the two, if it is determined, then we can come to have the loss tangent, and loss tangent is giving us the information how much lossy the given dielectric medium is. So there it is a requirement to concentrate to have the determination of this loss tangent, then we can have the determination of the dielectric constant in total. So now for the purpose of dielectric constant measurement, here we shall be opting the method by Roberts and von Hippel's method, in which the arrangement of the microwave test bench is like this. So in the block diagram, you can see a microwave source generating the microwave signal that has been transmitted through the pad called as the microwave isolator. Further, we have a connection to the frequency measurement unit, that it is frequency meter. Next to that, we have a slotted line which is mounted with the crystal detector, and finally it is connected to SWR meter or VSWR meter that we are already introduced to. Now at the second end of the slotted line, for the first end we have microwave source that has been incident here. Now we have the short circuiting at the last, and in between the slotted line and that of the short circuit assembly here, we use the dielectric sample material for which the dielectric constant is to be determined here. Now in this assembly, we can make some modification also. We can take out the dielectric material and we can directly connect the slotted line with the short circuited plates here. So because of this particular action, we can observe a shift into the minima position into the voltage standing wave pattern that can be seen onto the display here. Now here the shift into the minima position can be denoted by delta S. So delta S is equal to, and if for the dielectric material medium that has been initially introduced in between the slotted line and that of the short circuited plates, here we have the dimension measured, let us say either you denote it by T or small d to denote the thickness. So the thickness of the dielectric material can be physically measured here, and then we can make the computation of the quantity denoted as capital X here. So the quantity capital X is given by the formulation where we have lambda suffix g, the guide wavelength, divided by small d, the thickness of dielectric material, in multiplication to the tangential of the ratio of, where the numerator is 2 pi times in the bracket, the shift into the minimum of delta S added to small d, the thickness, which is divided by the guide wavelength lambda g here. So this is the quantity that is of very, very much importance. The calculation is X here. The Roberts and von Hippel have also compared this particular quantity x with another quantity, where we can have the formulation of x as tangential of 2 pi into capital V divided by capital V, where this capital V is the number of wavelengths into the microwave radiation. So I mentioned here number of wavelengths, so the wavelength inside the waveguide, hence I can write lambda sub g, and that it is further getting converted for the radiation purpose there. Now with respect to this relation, there it is a plot. So we have the plot of the quantity x with respect to the tangential of 2 pi v divided by capital V, where we come to see the relationship for the positive values obtained for the tangential, the negative values obtained for the tangential divided by V here, the negative values and again the positive values corresponding to the changes into the x quantity from 0 to 1.0 here. Now, from all these quantities to be measured here, we can finally determine the dielectric constant. The dielectric constant denoted by epsilon suffix r is now given as 1 minus, we have the ratio of lambda 0 to that of lambda suffix g here, guide wavelength. So it is to be squared and further added to lambda 0 into capital V divided by small d, which is to be squared here. So I outline this particular relationship which requires the dielectric constant to be measured, the requirement of the guide wavelength, the requirement of the wavelength in the unbound medium, that it means outside the waveguide, the thickness of the dielectric material, and the capital V, the quantity that has been represented in the earlier equation here. So by the next lecture, we shall try to conclude this particular chapter with addressing the topic noise factor measurement here. So I hope you enjoy learning the various topics associated with microwave engineering. For more such information and the details, you can subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you.